Hello, in this video I'm going to demonstrate how to install the Salesforce Commerce Cloud Google Channel. The first step is to download the repository from Salesforce Commerce Cloud. To do this, you will need your Commerce Cloud Account Manager credentials to access the repository. Once you've finished downloading the repo, change directories into the Social Channels Integrations folder and run npm install to install all the needed dependencies. In the next step, we will create our DWJSON file in the Social Channels Integrations folder. Replace the dollar sign strings with actual values from your environment. For the password field, you will need to generate a WebDev File Access and UX Studio Access Key. You can do this via Business Manager. In the next step, we will install social integration metadata that is common to all social channels. We've created npm scripts to try and make this process a little easier. Using the command line from the root of the repo, type npm run data import common. As you can see, running this command zipped, uploaded, and imported the common metadata to our sandbox. In the next steps, we're going to upload the Google cartridges to our active code version, as well as install Google-specific metadata. To begin, we'll head back to our command line and run npm run code upload Google to upload all the code cartridges we will need for the Google integration. Next, in order for our code cartridges to take effect, we will configure our cartridge paths for both our storefront site and our Business Manager site. First up, let's configure our Business Manager cartridge path. Next, we'll head back to the README and grab the cartridge path for our site. Now that we've finished the code configuration, let's import our Google-specific metadata. We'll again head back to the command line and run data import Google global. Same as before, this will zip, upload, and import our metadata to our sandbox. With all code metadata installed, now we're ready to begin the onboarding process via Salesforce Commerce Cloud Business Manager. First up, let's follow along the README to apply the necessary permissions. Head to Administration, Organization, Roles and Permissions to assign the Google Channel Social Channel. Next up, in the same area, we'll flip from Site Context to Organization Context and add the Social Product Feeds definition. To enable Google to download feeds from Salesforce Commerce Cloud, we'll need to create an API client and configure the WebDAV permissions for that client ID. In this step, we enable the WebDAV credentials for our client ID. For instructions on creating a client ID, please refer to the repo README. Next up, let's double check that our service credentials are pointing to the correct Google endpoint. For Commerce Cloud sandbox, development, and staging instances, we'll use the Google API pre-prod credentials. For production instances, we will want to use the API production credentials. Ensure the correct credentials are set for both the create and get service profiles. Next, we will review the catalog feed configuration. The Google product feed is powered by the custom feeds module. We can use the social product feeds business manager module to configure the fields we want to include in our product feed. A default template is automatically included as a starting point. After we've configured the fields to include in our product feed, let's review our job configuration in Business Manager via Administration, Operations, Jobs. Click into the Google Services Export job. For the Export Pricebook flow, configure the Pricebook IDs that you wish to export to Google. Do the same for the next two steps. For the Inventory List flow, configure the inventory list IDs that you wish to send to Google. For the export stores flow, configure the store IDs that you wish to send to Google. If you wish to send all store IDs, please just use the asterisk symbol. In the export product steps, ensure the custom object IDs match the feed ID from your social product feeds module. Update the host name parameter to your Commerce Cloud instance. After you've reviewed the job steps, click Run Now to export the product feed to the Salesforce Commerce Cloud Web Dev directories. This step needs to be completed prior to completing the Google onboarding form. After the job finishes successfully and the product feed has posted to Commerce Cloud Web Dev, we're ready to complete the Google onboarding form. In Business Manager, head to Merchant Tools, Social Channels, Google Channel to complete the onboarding form.